Welcome to the Beyond Football Show. Here's your host, Hannah Hall and Kate Lay.
Welcome back to the Beyond Football Show. As always, I'm your host, Hannah Hall.
And I'm Kate Lay, talking to you all things beyond football. How's your day, Hannah? How's everything going?
It's going good, you know, just another weekend at home, you know, COVID style. I'm coming from Fresno, California. Obviously, you know, you're from Stockton, kind of switching it back and forth between San Jose and Stockton. One thing I will say, I am the oldest of four, and I love my siblings very, very much. But they can drive me crazy. Do you have siblings? I don't know if we've ever even talked about this before, but what's that look like for you?
You know, I actually don't have any siblings. I'm actually an only child, so I don't really know what it's like to have an older sister or brother. I always wished that I had an older sibling, you know, if it was a sister or a brother, it really doesn't matter. So sometimes it gets really lonely. So not only that, but, you know, obviously my mom's my idol, but I wish I kind of had a mentor that was kind of closer to my age that kind of experienced the same things as me. So I never really had a mentor like that. But speaking of mentors, today we have a special guest, a mentor of himself. He actually mentors at Robert Sanders Elementary. We have Tysyn Parker today on our show. Let's give a warm welcome to Tysyn Parker.
Tysyn, it's good to have you. Please tell everyone listening to the Beyond Football Show a little bit about yourself, your major, your position on the field, and just introduce yourself. Let's hear it.
Well, I'm Tysyn Parker. I'm a senior linebacker. I'm a justice studies major. This will be my final year coming up, my last semester in college. I'll be graduating soon, so that's exciting.
All right. What's your major?
Justice studies.
Okay. All right, for sure. So let's just dive right into this. You're pretty well-rounded, and you have really shown interest in beyond football and everything that comes with it. So I want to ask you, what has sparked your interest in beyond football, and specifically regarding community outreach with the youth? I have gone through the pictures, I've gone through the videos, and I have seen a lot of Tysyn Parker with the kids. So can you tell me about that?
So, coming in my freshman year, we had a lot of like business type like opportunities to meet and like network with companies and stuff like that. And you know, obviously my major is justice studies, so I didn't really have any interest in like the tech companies and stuff like that. So I mean, TB offered mentoring, and we needed something to do in the spring to, you know, kind of build our resume, because obviously like most of us can't have jobs and we don't have any like experience. So
right.
Me coming in as a freshman, I didn't know that like the stuff that we do with TB can count towards resume building as well. So I mean, once she said that was an opportunity for me to build my resume, I took advantage of it. I enjoyed it, and I just kept going with it every time she, you know, offered it to us.
Definitely. I think that an important part of beyond football is that resume building process, and things like mentoring does help push that forward. It definitely looks good. Yeah. And it's something that, you know, teaches you a lot about responsibility and just really being that role model for these kids. My next question was, what is the importance of being a student athlete who gives back to the community? Obviously, especially in San Jose, we see that a lot of these elementary schools look up to our athletes, especially our football team. I mean, you guys are like superheroes in their eyes. Can you tell me about that?
Well, yeah, like, so I'm not from around San Jose, so obviously I don't know everything about the city. So, I mean, the mentoring gave me an opportunity to go out and explore. And then obviously you get to meet some of these kids and you understand, like, you know, they're not too much different than, you know, where I come from is, you know, not the most positive background, don't have the most, you know, well-rounded environment. So, you know, they do need student athletes or, you know, people that are doing something positive to kind of lead them in the right direction. And, right, kind of share their stories and struggles with them so they understand, like, you know, even though you have it rough right now, it can't be brighter at the end of the day.
Yeah, definitely. And I think that that's so important for these kids, especially in the San Jose area, obviously in any area, but specifically, yeah, with us, I think it's so important to have those role models, and especially seeing someone who they can look up to being a student athlete and providing that lot of experience, but
Yeah, no, I totally agree. And speaking of on positivity, you know, can you kind of explain a little bit more of your role in the mentoring program and kind of what your expectations were? Because, you know, you said that you were a freshman kind of going into this, you know, you never really expected to be a mentor, you know, and then also your kind of relationship with our director, TB, because I know she plays a really important role in your life as well.
Yeah, so like I said, my freshman year, starting off kind of the mentorship role for us were just to go and play with the kids and, you know, kind of just spend 30, 40 minutes with them outside. And if you guys, you know, happen to talk about whatever they were struggling with or anything like that, then, you know, that was just something that you could help them with. It wasn't necessarily part of what we were there to do. We were just kind of there to just run around with them, getting tired and, you know, have a good time. So, you know, as the program, as TB kind of got her footing in San Jose as well and started to reach out to all these schools, more, you know, principals started to reach out saying, okay, we have a group of kids that, you know, we would like to pair with players to come. And like, we sat down, did work with them, sat in the classroom with them, and then actually like talked to them. And then we got to play with them. So it was kind of like, all right, if you want to go play outside, let's sit down. Let's see what you did this week. Let's see if you had a good week, a bad week. If you're struggling with something, let's talk about it first. And then we could go outside and play. And that kind of was the reward for the kids, was the play time. And the serious time for the players was to actually sit down and try to, you know, help, you know, these kids when they're in school.
Yeah, and I know that we talked about, you know, having fun. Something that was brought to my attention was that you guys actually donated Adidas equipment to play with the kids. So kind of go on that and explain, you know, what was going through your head and what you saw, because I'm pretty sure those kids were so excited. I mean, it's Adidas equipment, you know, it's the big leagues, you know.
so that was all TB. TB, you know, did her research and somehow she won a grant or something along those lines. I'm not really too sure. But, you know, she thought it would be a good idea to buy, like, basketballs and, you know, rubber balls, footballs for the kids and surprise them one day. So, you know, I think like 2 weeks went by, we had all the equipment ready to go. And, you know, we're kind of happy too, because we're like, okay, we get to surprise the kids. We already know how they are when they want to go outside and play. So now we can give them like four basketballs, four footballs, like four, every little like ball that they could think of. And, you know, we're excited, like little kids ourselves, like, yeah, now we get to go play with the new stuff too. And it's not just the kids. So, I mean, they enjoyed it. It made everybody happy, made us happy, made them happy. TB was happy as well, just being able to do that for them.
Now, I know you mentioned a little bit about part of your mentorship program is talking with these kids, sitting down and talking about, was this week good? You know, what can we fix? Obviously, a mentor is super important to have in your life, just like me and Kate talked about in the beginning of this episode. Who has served as that mentorship role for you?
So like for me growing up, it was my brother. He was kind of my role model, kind of the male figure in my life, because I grew up without my dad. You know, as I kind of got older, you know, I've met more people, and since I've been in college, you know, I've been able to grow and have a good relationship with TB, and TB has kind of led me through the later part of my life, kind of guided me through career paths and stuff like that, and big decisions that I have to make in my life moving forward. So I'll say those are the two people that I looked up to, or my mentors.
And I want to ask you, what comes next for Tysyn Parker? I don't expect you to have the right answer. I don't expect you to know exactly what comes next, but do you have an idea of what you'd love to do? Because you do have this passion for helping others, and I think we see that with your, you said, criminal justice major, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I want to see how that's going to play into the future, and tell me about that. Like, what do you think comes next for you?
So once I'm done, you know, with sports, obviously, I've already kind of started my process with the San Jose Police Department. And then I'm going to venture and see where that takes me. I want to be a detective and then hopefully one day work for the FBI or CIA or something along those lines. And kind of, you know, just work my way around the world and trying to explore and then just help as many people as I can along the way. I'm not sure, you know, how I'm going to do that yet. But, you know, it's something we'll that I know I could do.
We always figure it out.
Yes, yeah. You know. Yeah. And our kind of last question is, you know, what advice would you give someone who's looking to give back to their community, you know?
Kind of just follow your heart. You know, don't always have to go for the home run and do something big for people. Sometimes it's the little gestures that go the longest way. And, you know, every little thing helps anybody. So it doesn't have to be monetary or, you know, material. It could be just advice, you know, a conversation.
Yeah, no, that is a really good piece of advice. So listeners, you know, take that piece of advice and just spread positivity and help your community out. So
yeah.
Thank you, Tysyn, for joining us today and being a part of our show. I know that spring ball is coming up, so I know that you guys have been pretty stressed, you know, so thank you for taking time out of your day. But before you leave, here at the Beyond Football Show, we like to spice things up. And you know you've been waiting for it. It is our song segment. Everyone has their favorite song. I know I do. I know Hannah does. And I know we can break it down on demand. So, Tysyn Parker, what is your favorite song? And can you spit some bars for us?
Oh, I got one.
Okay. All right. Tysyn.
Spoken.
Wait, hold on. I gotta make sure it's clean though.
Keep it PG for the kids.
Yeah, yeah. We gotta spread positivity.
Right,
yes, we do.
Good positivity. We keep it clean, on the football show.
My home, shorty, make me feel at home. Give me really the thrills at home, and I'm fine with it.
Hey.
She really made me lose control. I'ma let my love unfold. But you're just too lost souls, but I'm fine with it.
All right, that's it.
All right. We love it. Thanks for being a good sport. That's awesome.
No problem.
Little vibe sesh there with us. And I guess that can kind of conclude our episode, huh, Kate?
Yes, it does. Thank you to everyone for listening to our show, the Beyond Football Show. Tune in next week to find out who we talk to. Is it a coach? Is it an athlete? Is it a mentor?
We don't know.
But also check out our Instagram and our Twitter to find out the latest scoop with Beyond Football. Again, thank you, Tysyn, and we'll see you guys next week.
Thank you, guys. Bye. See ya.